Hey guys, I'm going to go over the city staff report and the city attorney memo and the new vendor slash expressive activity ordinance slash strikeout ordinance that was released to me a day before city council passed this ordinance into law. So without further ado, I'm going to go over what is going on. First, we're going to start with the city staff report. The staff report was issued on February 6th, 2024. Two honorable council members from Office of Councilmember Jennifer Campbell. Subject, municipal code amendments addressing concerns with sidewalk vending, commercial activity, and expressive activities on public property. Primary contact, Venus Molina. Overview. In the past year, we recognized the need to revisit and amend the San Diego Municipal Code to address concerns with sidewalk vending activities and to accommodate expressive activities while ensuring proper enforcement. We're introducing amendments that address activities protected by the First Amendment, sidewalk vending, impounding procedures, and enforcement mechanisms, as well as some necessary cleanup language. Proposed actions. Adopt an ordinance amending the municipal code related to sidewalk vending and expressive activities on public property. Discussion of item. Expressive activity. The primary goal of such amendments is to strike a balance between protecting First Amendment rights on the right hand and maintaining public safety, order, and accessibility on sidewalks, parks, benches, and the other. The proposal includes amending sidewalk vending ordinances to no longer exempt people engaged in expressive activities and propose new reasonable rules and regulations for people entangled in expressive activities to balance between protected constitutional rights and maintaining public order, ensuring that sidewalks remain accessible and the city's vibrant public spaces for expression and commerce. The fullest extent of First Amendment protections apply to what courts consider pure speech. Pure speech activities include activities like proselytizing, expressing religious, political, or ideological messages, artistic messages, nonprofit solicitations, and sales or distribution of original art or written materials. The city attorney's office has issued a memorandum of law, including in the backup of materials, that provides legal guidance on the limits of First Amendment places on local government regulation of speech activities and provides a comprehensive chart of frequent activities in public places and whether those activities are protected by the First Amendment. Examples of pure speech include speaking on a street corner in a park about a political, ideological, or religious topic. Distributing brochures. Art sales and art creation, including paintings, characters, balloon animals, sculpture, and other visual arts sold by the artist. Street performances, busking, face painting or henna tattoos. Distribution or sale of books, music, paintings, photographs, sculptures, or CDs or recordings created by the person selling the items. Examples of activities that are not considered pure speech include sales of handcrafts like jewelry, pottery, sales of personal care products including makeup, lotion, perfume, incense, and incense burners, sales of mass-produced items including clothing, hats, and food sales, teaching, exercise, yoga, or dog training classes, hair braiding, massage, application of skincare, makeup, or other products. The proposed regulations would clearly distinguish between expressive activity and vending activity to make clear for the public, law enforcement speakers, and vendors which set of rules of regulations apply to the specific activity. The mayor's office have expressed commitment to train law enforcement and city staff involved in enforcing these regulations to ensure fair and appropriate accurate application of these new regulations. Expressive activity regulations. The proposed regulations include a general time, place, manner rule that would apply to anyone engaged in protected First Amendment speech on city property, including space limit similar to the 24 limit applicable sidewalk vendors, a prohibition from using or attached equipment to city property, including utilities, and display setup provisions to ensure sidewalk and walkways are passable for safe and all people to use. City sidewalks should remain accessible to everyone, including those with mobile disabilities who need extra space to navigate. The ADA mandates that the city ensures a minimum of 8 feet passable space on sidewalks and walkways. The regulations guarantee that individuals engaging in expressive activities do so in a way that maintains safe and clear pathways for everyone. Additionally, these space requirements enable speakers to reach their intended audiences, as they are not confined to specific locations in the city parks or on sidewalks. Speakers can choose their setup location based on where they believe they can effectively connect with their audience, as long as the walkways and sidewalks remain unobstructed. The proposed regulations require all persons to engage in expressive activity using an application or non-amplified sound-making devices such as speakers, microphones, public address systems to comply with existing noise regulations in Section 59.5.0502F of the San Diego Municipal Code at all times, unless the person is an expressive activity area where louder amplification has been authorized for expressive activity by the city manager. Application of the city's existing noise limits is necessary to ensure that quiet hours are implemented to address and regulate excessive or disruptive noise levels that can negatively impact the tranquility of residential areas, public spaces, and businesses. Sound level limit, 7 a.m. to 7 p.m., 65 decibels. Sound level limit, 7:01 p.m. to 6:59 a.m., 55 decibels. The city manager may designate expressive activity areas in parks, plazas, and high traffic areas that are available on a first-come, first-served basis to persons who desire to use equipment, including a table, easel, stand, chair, umbrellas, sunshade, or other furniture as part of their expressive activity. The proposed regulations prohibit the purchase, sell, barter, or exchange of any space within an expressive activity area with another person, and a person may not reserve or hold space within an expressive activity area for another person. Any person who fails to comply may be asked to leave the expressive activity area and may be subject to penalties and fines. Before establishing an expressive activity area, the city manager must first determine that one of the following exists. There is a substantial interest in designating expressive activity areas to provide for a safe ingress and egress of all people and emergency public safety vehicles and personnel based on the existing path of travel, emergency and public safety access routes within a specific area of the park, plaza, or high-end traffic area. The capacity of the park, plaza, or high traffic area and the daily visitation rates are likely to create significant congestion on roads. Walkways such as passive travel are likely to be unpassable or unsafe. The nature of developed landscape could be damaged as a result of continual use of expressive activity if not contained to specific areas within park, plaza, or high traffic area. Or there is a substantial interest in designating expressive activity areas adjacent to events occurring in a park, plaza, high traffic area, including private events and permitted special events, when city manager determines expressive activity areas are necessary to provide for safe ingress and egress of persons of use of emergency and public safety access routes and in around the event. The city's ability to establish expressive activity areas is necessary because certain parks, plazas, and high traffic areas constitute major tourist attractions, hosting significant numbers of people annually and containing limited geographic space where visitors, tours, sidewalk vendors, and people engaged in expressive activity compete for space. Expressive activity regulations would apply to people engaged in protective speech. If the speaker draws a crowd, the speaker may be asked to comply with city regulations prohibiting blocking traffic within parks and other public places. Anyone who is not engaged in protective speech activities but is selling items on public property is a sidewalk vendor and must comply with the SVO. Amendments to the SVO and proposed new division would make this distinction clear. People who are not sidewalk vendors or engaged in covered expressive activity but want to engage in commercial activity in public areas like city parks and benches would be required to follow Municipal Code Section 63.0102C14 and get permit or other approval from the city in advance. impounding of sidewalk vending equipment, the need for impounding procedures, and increased enforcement measures arises from the challenges posed by rogue vendors who often disregard existing regulations and operate in a manner that disrupts public order and safety. These individuals have engaged in activities that obstruct sidewalks and create unsanitary conditions. Impounding provides a vital tool to swiftly address such issues by temporarily removing uncompliant vendors' equipment or goods. These measures aim to strike a fair balance between safeguarding the rights of legitimate vendors and maintaining the integrity of public spaces. Continuing the sidewalk vending ordinance requires progressive administrative enforcement as set forth by SB 946. Violations associated with any parts of the ordinance have been subject to escalating fines as set forth in the table below. First violation, written administrative warning and referral without permit, written administrative warning and referral. Second violation, with permit, $200, without permit, $500. Third violation, with permit, $500, without permit, $1,000. Fourth violation, $500 and or impoundment, without permit, $1,000 and or impoundment. The proposed amendments remove initial warning and replace it with a $100 fine for permitted vendors and $250 fine for unpermitted vendors. The sidewalk vendor who is fined for vending without vending permit provides proof of valid vending permit issued by the city that is applicable on the date of the violation. The administrative fine shall be reduced to the administrative fine schedule set forth in section 36.0110A. Since the sidewalk vending ordinance came into effect, city enforcement teams have encouraged groups of rogue vendors who exhibit a complete unwillingness to provide information or adhere to these established regulations. In response, we are proposing the adoption of impounding mechanism currently employed by the City of Orange that allow immediate impound of vendors' equipment or goods if the vending poses certain public health or safety concerns, including vending food without a valid health permit. See Attachment 1. The tool would grant enforcement officers the opportunity to immediately impound the vendor's equipment and product if they are found in violation of any impounding codes. The city may impound vending equipment and any goods therein for any of the following reasons: leaving vending equipment or goods unattended, vending prohibited goods in violation, vending with valid vending permit, vending food without a valid and displayed San Diego Environment Health Permit, vending in violation of the vision of sidewalk vendor refuses or fails to provide identification upon request by a city official, vending in violation of the division of sidewalk vendor refuses or fails to remove vending equipment for sidewalk park and or property within 30 consecutive minutes after being instructed to do so by an enforcement official, vending in a manner that blocks or obstructs the free movement of pedestrians or other traffic on sidewalks and fails to maintain a minimum of 48 inches of accessible path or travel. Now I want to stop here and go to this 48 inches. 48 inches is 4 foot. Up at the top, they're talking about how ADA needs 8 foot. So they're not even clear on how much space needs to be accessible. One moment it's 48 inches, which is 4 foot. Another moment it's 8 foot. I think they really need to get on board with a clearer message there, because this contradicts each other. Anyways, we'll go back to what's being said. Vending in a manner that creates an immediate and substantial danger or environmental hazard to health, safety, or general welfare of the public or property at the location of the vending equipment. Examples include discharge of oil, grease, or other slippery substance without any effort to maintain best management practices. Using unapproved portable cooking equipment, heating equipment, gas, fuel, appliance, generator, or open flame. Using cooking equipment without fire extinguisher or vending during urgent or an emergency public safety event or incidents. Vending by a sidewalk vendor who has, within a 24-month period, been issued 3 or more administrative citations for violations of this division. Vending equipment or goods that are evidence of a crime or booked as property after arrest of sidewalk vendor a violation of any local state law or federal laws or regulations, excluding this division, may be impounded in accordance with the San Diego Police Department applicable policies and procedures. City may immediately dispose of impounded goods that cannot be safely stored as they are perishable. Any owner of impounded vending equipment or any goods may, within 10 days, request an administrative hearing before a hearing officer by the city. The city manager may provide the person with whom the goods or vending equipment were taken with a receipt and instructions for retrieval of the impounded items, excluding any items that were disposed of. The receipt and instructions shall either be given to the person from whom the items were taken at the time of impound, or shall be mailed within 2 business days of the impound to address received by the city when the person applied for the vending permit. Impounding vending equipment and goods, excluding any items that were disposed of, will be released to the sidewalk vendor or owner, providing the proper proof of ownership is presented and the city receives payment in full of all administrative costs incurred as a result of the violations. Any unclaimed items will be considered abandoned and forfeited to the city after 90 days following impoundment. Additional changes. The proposed amendment includes other changes to reconcile existing code sections with state law and the SVO, repeal prohibitions on fortune-telling and similar activities protected by the First Amendment, incorporate different parks into the SVO that was adopted by City Council in 2023. City Strategic Plan Goals Objective. Goal 2, work in a partnership with all communities to achieve safe and livable neighborhoods. Objective 1, protect lives, property, and environment through timely and effective response in all communities. Goal 3, create and sustain a resilient and economically prosperous city. Objective number 1, diversity of growth of the local economy. It's weird how they have number 1 twice. Fiscal considerations. The cost to the administrator. The amendments have not been determined. City staff is currently determining the cost associated with the implementation. Charter Section 225, Disclosure of Business Interests. There is no contract associated with this action. And then it goes on about how there's an environmental impact. This activity amendments to the sidewalk vending ordinance to address concerns with sidewalk vending and expressive activities and is not a project subject to CEQA pursuant to CEQA guidelines, Section 1538378. And 15060C2 and 3, and the activity will not result in direct or reasonably foreseeable indirect physical charge change in the environment. Pursuant to state law, cities are not permitted to disallow sidewalk vending within a public right-of-way except where their restriction is directly related to subject health, safety, or welfare concerns. Proposed amendments to San Diego Municipal Code concerns with sidewalk vending activities are intended to accommodate expressive activities while ensuring property enforcement and while remaining within the provisions of SB 946. With these amendments, new legally enforceable regulations would be put in effect that would, among other things, include general time, place, and manner rules that would apply to anyone engaged in expressive activity or protected under First Amendment speech or on public property, and would provide sidewalk vending impoundment procedures and enforcement mechanisms. The amendment also includes definitions to provide clarity on the sidewalk vending ordinance, as sidewalk vending and expressive activities are already occurring on the public right-of-way. And these amendments are merely allowing the city to maintain the integrity of the public right-of-way. These amendments would not result in significant effects to the environment. Finally, these amendments are determined to be project subject CEQA and would nevertheless be exempt pursuant to CEQA guidelines in Section 15301. Existing facilities, as the proposed amendments would involve continuous use of existing public facilities, i.e. sidewalks, and would not result in the expansion of the existing use of these public facilities as discussed above. Equal opportunity contract information if applicable. Venus Molina, Chief of Staff, Council District 2. Alright, so there's some discrepancies here. And we went over some of this stuff at the staff meeting, but it seems like they're just kind of confused and don't really understand some of this stuff. The decibels is kind of low. I think it should be 75 decibels for the day and 65 at night. That's just me. And then that whole thing where they talk about 8 feet and then they went down to 48 inches. It's just, that's kind of ridiculous. They need to get on the page with that, get on the same page and get that reconciled to where it's clear and concise and not one or the other, depending on which one the ranger sees and reads on any given day or time. Yeah, so this is the staff report. I'm going to end this video now and start again on the next thing, which is the city attorney memo.